Probably king. Secure king, yeah. Market analysis, market breakdown. Today is the 19th September 2021. It's Sunday, 33 minutes past four. If you want to be as exact, anyway, so I'm going to be analyzing, predicting, forecasting gold, NASDAQ, US30, USD CAD, and Euro CAD. Okay, so yeah, so I'm not, I already have draw, I've drawn structure and everything, so I'm not still gonna erase it and draw it again. So I just want to keep it plain, short, and simple so we can see opportunities, or you guys can see what I see, or what this next week has in store for us. So at this moment, right, I'm looking at gold from the daily, and gold is in a bearish channel, right? So gold is in a bearish channel. And I've also discovered we were in this type of mini blue channel and we broke out, as you can see, retest, and then we continue to the downside. But as you can see right over here, this is the 90% rule, right, of this channel. So it has actually reached the 90% rule. And so now we can wait for further continuation down to the downside, because I am actually targeting these lows over here, as you can see. But as I trade, I always trade with the current structure, right? So as you can see, that's the resistant low over here. Previous, it was a triple bottom, but like we have that concept at the back of our mindset, right? So over here as well, we can see this was a resistant. As you can see, one, two, three, multiple touches. So it's a strong resistant, to be honest. But I like to keep it to the most recent, right? So, and this is on the daily. So we broke, we broke, retest, they broke. So I'm actually anticipating for the price to actually come over here and reach these lows over here, right? But tomorrow or the week that lies ahead of us, I'm gonna be more patient, because gold likes to, like, it gives you that massive impulse move, and then it gives you like 2, 3 days of consolidation, or to create a nice pattern, you know. So I'm gonna be waiting for gold to maybe give me something like this, then come to the downside, some continuation pattern to take to the downside, obviously. Or if gold doesn't give me that, I'll be waiting for something like this, gold to come retest over here and come back over here, right? So I'm gonna be very patient on gold. And as you can see, this is just a daily. So I like analyzing on the daily to see how my candles close, right? So that I can get a nice picture. So as you can see, gold moved like everyone in my premium, in my mentor. So we got this, we got this beautiful, beautiful trade. So gold gave us this expanding nature over here, expanding pattern, as you can see, was beautiful. Came back, impulse, correction, went to the downside. As you can see, first touch, second touch, third touch, and gold sold, like we capitalized so much from gold. Like, guys, I don't trade a lot of, like, I trade like everything, but every week I like have like one trade specifically that I have laser focus and just keep on it, you know, because I don't want to, I have my watch list and so, but like I just want to keep it plain and simple, not being all focused or all over the place, you know. You want to have single-minded focusness within the game. Anyway, so I'll be looking for gold to like give me something like a nice continuation pattern over there, you know. Because for now, it's still too early to decide what gold has in store for us. So I'm just going to keep it low-key, you know. Just keep it. Anyway, that's what I have for gold, right? I'll update you guys, my mentors, my mentees within my VIP group, about how we're going to capitalize more on gold and if I see opportunities. Anyway, let's move on. US30. Let's just go to US30. Go from the daily. US30 looks bearish. Like, I like taking buys with US30 and NASDAQ more than sells. So that's basically, I try to stay away from sales, you know. But anyway, we can trade sells and buys. So as you can see, we have this channel over here for US30. So sorry for the background, guys. I do apologize. I also apologize for any background voices or sounds that you might hear. Super apologize. Anyway, so as you can see, this is a bullish trend, right? US30. So as you can see, first touch, second touch. So I'm anticipating the market to come over here to anticipate more buys, right? And as you can see over here, we had something like this. This was also our first touch, second touch, third touch. I capitalized here, but it has actually broken out of that trend, you know, out of that channel. So I'm looking for something to the downside, to continue to the downside, right? So I like, the main focus is, guys, like, to always stay patient for that picture perfect setups, you know. Don't like be all over the place. If someone says buy, you go buy. No, stick to your strategy, stick to what you know best, right? And as you can see, it looks beautiful, right? It's showing us a nice, beautiful bearish channel. As you can see, if you want to draw it like accurately or anything like that. So I would how I would go in with this, I would still wait for the market to show me something, right? Because like as you can see, it's a bearish channel on a 4 hour. Alright, so I would trade the bearish channel, wait for the market to basically get over here, take some sales over here, you know what I'm saying? Just like to continue all the way to the downside. But anything can happen because like it's still too like early to establish, right? So look at this. I want to show you guys this as well. On US 30, like on US 30, I will see this, right? So we know in a bullish trend, right? The market moves basically like this, as I showed you guys previously on my YouTube channel or so. Market moves like this, right? So it's impulse, correction, impulse. So let me just show you something. If it's an impulse, correction, impulse. Wait, let me just do this a bit more down. If it's like an impulse, sorry about that, guys. Impulse, correction, impulse, correction, right? So we've established that this low, higher low, right? High, higher high. But you see this low over here, right? If the market has not broken this low, we can still establish it as a bullish trend. Right, so if the market could take this and that could be a double bottom, right? But if the market comes down, breaks that low, right, retest the same low, creating another trend, right, a bearish trend. So that's how I would go about this trade, right? And that's how I would like trends changing within trends, right? So like a bullish trend change to a bearish trend, basically like that. So at this moment, right, you can see this low. But this is a significant area, you see, because the market has actually been respecting this low from in the bullish channel. Every time the market comes over here, it rejected and treated it as support. But as you can see over this, the market has actually broken that support, right? So it's a bit for me, to be honest, it's a bit for me too early to decide whether I'm going to still take some buys or some sells, right? Because if the market does present something like this to me, right, come over here, present something, I would wait for my 1 hour candlestick confirmation to enter, present something like this, you know, move to the upside. And then I would easily take something like this over your buyer, or if I see a candlestick confirmation to be more risky, I would enter buys here, right? But remember, there's a bearish the channel. So if the market does come over here and present something for me over here, to take it to the downside, I would obviously take it to the downside, right? Because I see there's more selling pressure, the momentum is more. Bears is more like in charge, as you can see. Look at the candles of the bears, like as the bearish channel. It's more momentum within the bearish channel than the bulls, right? Than the green candles, obviously. So we know the bears is actually in charge over here. So at this moment, my entry criteria will be something like this over here. If I see a push and then a push up, then I will see a correction on the 5 minute or 50 minute, take it to the upside, right? Just targeting there. These over here, right? So let me just erase. Oh, if I see something like this, market present itself, something like this. Boom. I would enter there, right? But you guys must understand the market could do like we adapt and evolve, right? I trade what I see, I don't trade what I think. So the market could even like come back over here, boom, come over here, test this whole thing, this whole trend line, and then move to the downside. It's always possibilities versus probabilities, you know, but nonetheless, we will see what the other market opens and see if there's opportunities with US 30. Nasdaq is basically the same, similar, I wouldn't say the same. Similar, basically, let's go to Nasdaq. It's on daily. As you can see over here by Nasdaq, nice channel over here, waiting for that touch. As you can see, first touch, second touch, waiting for the third touch, right, to move back to the upside. And as you can see, there's a bullish trend, right, bullish channel, but there's another channel within. So first touch, second touch, third touch, waiting for this and move to the upside, right? So that's possibilities versus probabilities. I would wait for the market to come over here, give me some type of indication, maybe it can move back to the upside and then drop, right? But this is an area that I want to see, or the market could actually be breaking this area, give some type of continuation pattern, and then move to the downside over here to these zones. So that's what I want to see, right? And that's what I'm looking at. I always trade within like channels. I trade within trends, right? I do not confuse myself with anything. Anyway, so at this moment, we can see this bear. The bears are in charge, right? The bears are in charge. So Monday, to be honest, I just want to see what's going to happen at this zone. I don't want to trade anything. I don't trade support and resistance. I wouldn't do something like this. Like, I know most traders do this, trade something like this. They're looking for support there. No, that's not me. I don't trade like that. I would rather wait for the market to come over here, you know, come over here, then maybe move to the upside, right? Or the market actually breaks that continuation pattern, moving to the downside, right? That's it, guys. And that's on the 4 hour. We're not going to go into depth with NASDAQ. That's it. So either this, let me just draw it for you guys. This happens, boom. Either that happens, right? Or something like this, it breaks below. Breaks below. Right, that's it, plain and simple. So just stick for 2 seconds, count one, count twice, gone. Anyway, that's what I have on NASDAQ. Let's look at my wild cards, actually. I'm gonna look at USD CAD. Because I've been looking at this for a week or two, 3 weeks, like 3 weeks or two. It doesn't, took some L's here, but I understand how it moves now. So I actually have some nice swing trade opportunities. So my two wild cards is USD CAD and Euro CAD, right? But like, it could take this week to play out. It could take next week to play out. Like, I like sticking, like I like being very patient, right? So as you can see over here, right? Like, I don't want to still to draw stuff. I'm just gonna like show you what I have, right? So this whole thing for me is basically a nice continuation, right? Like, I'm looking for a nice continuation to the downside, because I see a pattern is being formed over here, right? So the overall pattern that I see is over here, right? So it's always possibilities versus probabilities, right? And as you can see, like, I like keeping my charts plain and simple. So I like to like draw this eye, right? I'm going to show you why I'm drawing my eye over there, right? Because like, I don't want to do this until show you, oh, okay, cool. It actually connects over there. It makes sense. No, I'm not like that. I trade with the current structure, right? Current structure. So let me show you what I have on the daily, right? So as you can see, this is massive bearish momentum over here. So I'm looking at this for a continuation pattern. Some people can have it like this, like whatever jiggles your joystick, basically. So you can have something like this, right? I wouldn't actually draw it. So let's just erase it. Let me just not confuse you guys. So let me just show you what I have. Something like that, right? So let me show you my probabilities. Market could be coming over here, breaking. I want the market to break this high, because once it's broken this high, it created another high, which establishes that is a nice trend, the bullish trend. And the market, once it creates another high, it's going to come back to the downside. And this is a daily, as you can see. So there's a lot of pips to capitalize. So I would want my first setup to be that market breaks above, breaks below, give us a first push down, and we target in it to the downside. That's my first probability, right? Second probability is basically the same here. This could be our push down. This could be our correction over there. Market can give us a third test, then break to the downside, right? That's what I would, I'm only going to stick to that too. So let's go on the 4 hour. Guys already probably got a concept of the picture. So on the 4 hour, right, as you can see, like I just now informed you guys, we either break above there, give a first push to the downside, first continuation pattern, and then move to the downside. We can have that, right? Or we can actually even have a third touch over there. You know, we get a push like this. This would be beautiful. First push to the downside, then we take it on the continuation, and then boom, we're targeting all over here. And this is a nice swing trade. So this is going to be a beautiful, beautiful opportunity. Hope we can get into this. Or we could be looking at something like this. As you can see, this is the first impulse. So this could be a bigger flag. Actually, so we could have something like this. The market could be giving us something like this over here, what we're going to see, and then move to the downside, right? So that's possibilities versus probabilities for USD CAD. Let's move. Anyway. Euro CAD. Go on the daily. Similar setups, actually. As you can see, heavy momentum to the downside. Let's zoom in. Got this pattern structure over here, you know. So for me, actually, I could see, I would wait for the third touch, right? As you can see, one touch, two touch. I'm waiting for the third touch because, like, look at this. I see this impulse, right? This could be a corrective nature over here. Then move to the upside, waiting for the third touch, then move to the downside. That would be beautiful because look at this. This is a nice correction nature over here and then move to the upside. So that would be a beautiful trade. That's actually what I'm hoping to see, right? So as you can see, I'm waiting for that one touch, two touch, that third touch over here, and then move back to the downside. So that's basically what I have. Let me go on the 4 hour just like to show you guys like in depth what I actually have. So this here is just patterns within patterns, right? So like over here, as you can see, this pattern over here is basically just my correction. So this will be like impulse here, corrective nature over here. Move to the upside, give us a third touch and move to the downside, right? So that's basically it. If you want to capitalize on maybe this, you could be waiting for something like this on the 1 hour. If it presents itself, like I'm not very keen on it. I'll push to the upside, retest of this zone, and then move to the down, to the upside, right? Talking this. But when I'm mostly looking for sales. So when the market reaches over here, I'll be looking for something like this. First push to the downside, take that correction, and then going continue to the downside. So that's basically it that I have on EuroCAD and USD CAD. So that's it. Stay safe, guys. Hope you guys learned something about the Shaquille King out, you know. We out here making moves. We out here making moves. So yeah, stay safe, guys. Stay safe.